Hello and welcome to Monmouth In Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County Government. I'm your host, Cynthia Scott. Today we are joined by Freeholder Gerry Scharfenberger, who is here to talk to us about two of the county's departments. First of all, thanks so much for having us here, for you being here on Monmouth In Focus. Always a pleasure to see you, Gerry.
Thank you for having me.
So we're talking about two departments within county government that contribute so much, but one of them kind of like the unsung heroes, purchasing. Tell us about that.
Right, purchasing, and you're right, it is something that people don't really think of when they think of county government, but it's really responsible for all of the purchasing, everything from small items like pencils and pens, up to very large items like general goods and supplies for road repairs, things like that, and everything in between. So it really is a very important and very, very heavily utilized office.
Mm-hmm. And it's funny, we were talking before about, you go into a store, you need something, you buy it, mm-hmm. and that's that. So much goes in, so much detail goes into a purchasing department when it comes to county government. You have to decide who you're going to purchase goods from. What's the process there?
Well, it's very complicated. It's not like a regular business or even a household where you would go shop around and just go and purchase with a credit card. Here, there are very strict laws set down by the state purchasing laws that we have to follow. And you have to buy from approved vendors that are on a state list, and sometimes you have to go out to bid if it's over a certain amount. There's a $17,500 threshold, which means everything has to go out to bid. So you really want it to be as fair and as open as possible, and everything is done that way, everything down to supplies up to very large items and services.
And sometimes it's could be a lengthy process.
It could be, yeah. And you certainly, when you go out to bid and you have certain bid specs, things that are written into a bid, that if the county doesn't get what they're looking for, then it has to be rebid again. Mm-hmm. So it's a very complicated process, and it's something that it's very important because it can keep the county out of trouble, and you really want to do everything on the up and up. And our audits have shown that purchasing has been very effective as far as paying invoices timely, making sure that everything's done right and mm-hmm. follows the state law.
So my next question is, how do the vendors find out how to get the business mm-hmm. from the county?
Well, we do advertise on our website, so they can go in and look at what services or goods we're looking to purchase or what services we're looking to engage, and that's the way they find out a lot. But some of them are very creative, where if they read about a project maybe upcoming, they will contact somebody in the county and mm-hmm. say, listen, I'd be interested in bidding, can you give
sure.
me more information? So in this day and age with the internet and websites and everything, it's very, very easy to stay tuned in without having to look for a small ad in the paper the way it used to be years
exactly.
ago.
Exactly, yeah.
So that's really the best way, or to contact somebody if they're a little unsure, and they're very, very willing to help and make sure that we get as big a pool as prospective vendors mm-hmm. in there.
Sure, I bet you, and like you said, with the internet and social media, it probably is a more competitive market mm-hmm. as well today.
It absolutely is, yes.
Yeah. So I would imagine that a lot of our viewers don't realize the amount of work and the amount of departments that county government has.
Mm.
Another big part of county is human resources.
Right.
So
right.
tell us a little bit about what goes on there.
Well, human resources is really charged with all issues with personnel, with hiring, maintaining, benefits and things like that. They're an information source. And also when there's conflicts. They step in and sort of mediate that, and we have very strict and somewhat complex civil service laws mm-hmm. that we have to deal with, so they're very, very well versed in that. And we have 2,500 to 3,000 employees at any given time,
sure.
Everything from part-timers who are more transient to people who are more permanent and stay for us for years.
Mm-hmm.
And they handle all sorts of problems, and again, they follow the law, but also they use a lot of wisdom. You're dealing with 2,500, 3,000 personalities.
Sure.
And I'm just amazed and in awe of some of the things that they're able to resolve without it really blowing up. So they do a tremendous job, and dealing with some of the complexities of civil service can be challenging,
yeah.
and they do a tremendous job.
Yeah, civil service can definitely be tough, sometimes confusing,
mm-hmm.
Especially when it comes to the hiring process or who's number one on the list, things like that, even, right? It's tough.
It is. Mm-hmm. And, when there are people vying for jobs or mm-hmm. promotions or positions, it can get a little bit complicated and
mm-hmm.
testy, mm-hmm. and you need somebody who can really, a department who can really navigate that, and they do it so well. We're very,
yeah.
very happy with
it. Yeah, they need to understand the law as well, and a lot mm-hmm. of them are not attorneys.
Right, right. But they know that particular law.
Yeah.
And they know the system. And they even know the players, too. They get to know the personnel, and that's really good. And since I've been on the board, I've gotten to know HR very well and have been super impressed with the work they do and just the job that they're doing on a daily basis and keeping things running smoothly, because we need a performance from employees. We need certain employees to fill certain positions, and once they're there, we need the performance out of them, and they seem to keep the county running really well and smooth.
Sure. And Freeholder, you had obviously can't come from municipal government, a rather large municipality, Middletown.
Right.
But even so, I would imagine, you know, going from Middletown to the county is was somewhat of a wide gap in a sense, because you know, you still went from one town managing to county government with 53 municipalities.
Right, and you have to get used to everything bigger. We had 330 employees maybe in Middletown. Now it's almost 10 times that. So you get to know people after a while, but now it's taking a little bit longer, and I'm trying to make the rounds where I go to different departments. They're scattered throughout the county for the most part, and every time I meet people who work for the county, again, I'm impressed. On the way here, I saw a road crew and waved to them, so a lot of them knew me already, and they're out there doing a tremendous job. And it's really a credit, I think, to HR and to the county, too, that they're able to attract good people, but also retain them at the degree they have.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And you are a liaison to what departments?
Well, human resources, IT, finance, certainly the county medical examiner, the administrator, you know, those sorts of more internal type departments.
And so, but I would imagine you're coming from Middletown, your background as mayor and committee man really prepared you to become a Freeholder. I mean, when you think about it logically, that is the next great step.
It is. It's a great training ground. It's the AAA of the county of government. And getting to know the DPW in Middletown was a good entree into coming on to the county and working with the Department of Public Works and the road folks there. So it was a great, great training ground and easily transferable to here to the county.
All right. Well, best of luck in all of your future endeavors with the Monmouth County Board of Chosen Freeholders. Keep up the great work.
Thank you very much.
So happy to have you aboard.
Same here. Thank you.
All right, Freeholder. Thanks so much. And for more information, of course, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.